In this video, we will discuss about what is frame of reference. So, till now, we have always studied about coordinate system. But now, we will discuss frame of reference and how this frame of reference, it is different from the coordinate system. So, actually, a frame of reference is the system relative to which motion of any object can be described. As in the previous video, as in the previous lecture, I have already told you that motion is a relative term, not an absolute. So, we need any system relative to which the motion of any object can be described. And that system is known as frame of reference. So, how this frame of reference, it is different from the coordinate system? It has one difference. In case of coordinate system measures only the position coordinates of the object, not time. So it will tell us only about x, y, z, means position coordinates. But frame of reference, it measures the position coordinate of the object as well as the time coordinates. Means x, y, z, t. It gives us the knowledge of x, y, z, t. So we can say that frame of reference is a more general concept than this coordinate system. So basically we can say that because frame of reference, it tells us about the position coordinates x, y, z. So it is a coordinate system, but it also has a clock which will tell us time coordinate. So what is a frame of reference? It is actually a coordinate system together with the clock fixed in it, that is known as frame of reference. So frame of reference bache ki hai, agar tuhade kol ikalla coordinate system hai fir to coordinate system hi hai, but agar ode vich clock vi hai jehda tuhanu time dega, then that is the combination of the collection of coordinate system and the clock which is fixed in it, that is known as frame of reference. So here you can see, this is the representation of a coordinate system and this is the representation of a frame of reference. So here this is a clock which will tell us time. Now there are lab frame of references as well as CM frame of references, means center of mass frame of reference. What are these? Laboratory frame of reference is the frame of reference which is attached to earth or which is fixed with respect to earth. So lab frame is a frame of reference in which all the experiments are performed and it is fixed to earth. And what is this center of mass frame? Center of mass frame is the frame of reference which is attached to the center of mass of the system on which we are performing experiment. And actually these frame of references, they are of two types. This is most important from the examination point of view. So frames of references, they are of two types: inertial frames of references and non-inertial frame of references. Now, as the name indicates, inertial. What are these inertial frame of references? Inertial frame of references are the frames in which Newton's law of inertia holds. So, what will be the non-inertial frame in which Newton's law of inertia doesn't hold? So, if in inertial frame, Newton's law of inertia holds, and what is the statement of Newton's law of inertia? That if a body is at rest or is moving with uniform motion or is moving with constant velocity, then it will continue to do so unless and until some external force is acting on it. So inertial frames are the frames in which if a body is at rest, it will be at rest, and if a body is moving with uniform motion or with constant velocity, it will continue to do so. This is the definition of inertial frame. So we can say that all those frames which are at rest with respect to one another or which moves with the uniform velocity with respect to one another, or you can say that all those frames which are in uniform translatory motion with respect to one another, all these are inertial frames. All those frames will be inertial frames which are at rest with respect to one another or which are moving with uniform or constant velocity with respect to one another. And the frames which are not at rest or don't move with uniform velocity with respect to one another, they are known as non-inertial. And if the frames or the body in inertial frame of reference, it moves with uniform velocity, means acceleration is zero. If the velocity is constant, then acceleration will be zero. It means the inertial frame of references are the unaccelerated frames of references. Because if velocity is constant, then dv by dt is acceleration. So acceleration will be zero of a constant quantity. Time derivative will be zero. And what are non-inertial frame of references? Because in this case, velocity is not uniform. It means these are non-inertial frames are accelerated frame of references. Here, one frame, it will be accelerating with respect to another frame. And also, if one frame, it is rotating with respect to another frame, that is also known as non-inertial frame. So this is all about the definition of inertial frames and non-inertial frames. And in this chapter, later, we'll discuss these inertial frames and non-inertial frames in detail. Now, what is the principle of relative motion? And it is also known as Newtonian principle of relativity. According to this principle of Newton, it states that all the inertial frames, they are equivalent. All the inertial frames are equivalent, and all the basic laws of mechanics or physics, they hold equally in all the inertial frames. They hold good in all the inertial frames. Now, we'll discuss this. We will prove this Newtonian principle of relativity with example. So this is the example which will show us the Newtonian principle of relativity. Suppose we have two observers, observer A and observer B. Observer A is actually inside the train, which is standing on the platform. Train is standing on the platform. It means initially the train is at rest. And the observer A, he is inside a train. And what about observer B? Observer B, it is standing on the platform. And this observer A, he is having a ball. And what he does, he throws that ball vertically upwards. Now, you can see the train is at rest. Observer is sitting inside the train. It means observer A is also at rest. And this observer A has a ball and he throws that ball vertically upwards. And what is the observation made by observer A? That ball returns vertically downward to him. But what will be the observation made by observer B? Same observation will be made by observer B. सो एक्चुअली बच्चे की है इत्थे ट्रेन रेस्ट ते है उहदे विच ऑब्जर्वर ए है वह भी रेस्ट ते है ऑब्जर्वर ए को बॉल है वह बॉल नू वर्टिकली अपवर्ड थ्रो कर रहा उपर थ्रो कर रहा तो जदों ट्रेन भी रेस्ट ते है ऑब्जर्वर ए भी रेस्ट ते है तो बॉल है जिहड़ी उहदे को वर्टिकली डाउनवर्ड आएगी उहनू लगेगा कि बॉल सीधी गई तो सीधी उहदे को नीचे आई सो वर्टिकली अपवर्ड एंड वर्टिकली डाउनवर्ड डिस्टेंस है जिहड़ा उह ट्रैवल करेगी बॉल ਤੇ ਜੋ ਬੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਪਲੇਟਫਾਰਮ ਤੇ ਖੜਾ ਟ੍ਰੇਨ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਹਰ ਹੈ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਸੇਮ ਉਦਾਂ ਹੀ ਲੱਗੇਗਾ ਕਿ ਏ ਨੇ ਬਾਲ ਥਰੋ ਕੀਤੀ ਤੇ ਉਹ ਵਰਟੀਕਲੀ ਅਪਵਰਡ ਗਈ ਦੈਨ ਵਰਟੀਕਲੀ ਡਾਊਨਵਰਡ ਗਈ ਵਾਪਸ ਉਹਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਹੀ ਏ ਕੋਲ ਹੀ ਨਾਓ ਵਟ ਹੈਪਨਸ ਸਪੋਜ਼ ਦ ਟ੍ਰੇਨ ਹੈਜ਼ ਸਟਾਰਟਡ ਮੂਵਿੰਗ ਵਿਦ ਸਮ ਯੂਨੀਫਾਰਮ ਵਿਲੋਸਟੀ ਮੀਨਸ ਕੋਂਸਟੈਂਟ ਵਿਲੋਸਟੀ ਨਾਓ ਅਗੇਨ ਇਫ ਟ੍ਰੇਨ ਇਜ਼ ਮੂਵਿੰਗ ਵਿਦ 50 ਕਿਲੋਮੀਟਰ ਪਰ ਆਰ ਦ ਪਰਸਨ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਇਨਸਾਈਡ ਹੂ ਇਜ਼ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਇਨਸਾਈਡ ਦ ਟ੍ਰੇਨ He will also move with 50 kilometer per hour. So, to that person, train is at rest because motion is relative. Train is moving with 50 kilometer per hour with respect to observer B, who is standing on the platform. It means train seems to be at rest for the person, for the observer A, who is inside the train. And now this observer A, he is repeating the same experiment of throwing the ball upward. And what he observes the same thing, that even when the train is moving and a person is inside that train and he is throwing the ball upwards and the ball is returning vertically downward to him. Same observation made by him. But what will be the observation made by this observer B? How can this person made observation can make a observation? Because train has just started to move. This observer V, he can see the person A, observer A, throwing the ball upwards and then the motion of the ball downwards back to him. So, but during this time when the train is in motion, the observation made by observer B will be different. According to observer B, the ball, it is covering the parabolic path before returning to A. So, when everything is at rest, at that time the observations in the train made by the person in the train and made by the person which is who is standing outside the platform, the observations are same. But when the train is moving with uniform velocity, at that time observation made by person A is different who is inside the train and observation made by person B is different. So what conclusions we can draw from this? So we find that the observer A who is inside the train, he cannot tell whether the train is at rest or moving. Because the speed of velocity of the train with respect to observer A is zero and the velocity of observer A with respect to train is zero. But actually the train is moving. So the observer A who is inside the train, he cannot tell or distinguish whether the train is moving or not. Why? Because he observes the exactly same thing with the ball even when the train is at rest or in uniform motion. So what conclusion we can draw from this? That it is not possible to detect the state of rest or of uniform motion by performing mechanical experiments within that system itself. So, bachche ide vich eh hai ki agar assi kise system da dasna chahunde hain ki oh system rest te hai ya motion ch hai, uniform motion ch hai, to sanu eh detect karan layi agar assi ose system de vich hi beh jaane hain ਤਾਂ ਬੱਚੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਹ ਦੱਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਕਦੇ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਰੈਸਟ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਮਤਲਬ ਅਗਰ ਕੋਈ ਬੰਦਾ ਓਬਜ਼ਰਵ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਕਿ ਕੋਈ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਰੈਸਟ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਬੰਦਾ ਉਸ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਦਾ ਪਾਰਟ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਉਸ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਬਾਹਰੋਂ ਦੇਖੇਗਾ ਫਿਰ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗੇਗਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ 'ਚ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਰੈਸਟ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਅਗਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿਦ ਰਿਸਪੈਕਟ ਉਹਦੀ ਸਪੀਡ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋਏਗੀ ਵਿਲੋਸਿਟੀ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋਊਗੀ ਦੈਨ ਉਹ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ 'ਚ ਹੈ ਅਗਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਏਗੀ ਤਾਂ ਦੈਨ ਉਹ ਰਸਤੇ ਹੈ So it is not possible to detect the state of rest or of uniform motion of a system by performing mechanical experiments within that system itself. So here A, he gets the same result because he is the part of that system. He is a part of that train. Now second, the observations made by A and B both are different when the train is moving. But these observations, they can be explained by using same laws of mechanics. Because laws of mechanics remains same or remains unchanged under uniform motion in any frame of reference. So this is all about Newtonian's principle of relativity. And one more thing, length, mass and time, according to Newtonian mechanics, or you can say that classical mechanics, Newtonian mechanics is the branch of classical mechanics. So according to Newton, length, mass and time, all three are constants and independent of each other. Remember this. And in the next lecture, we will discuss Galilean transformations, one of the most important topic, and the basis of this and the next unit.